Yo, what's up, fam? My name is Musky Bud. Welcome back. We are coming at you live from the University of George Brown campus. And I'm going to have to change a little sum here. What is that, your Twitter right there?
You have to add an 8.
An 8?
Yes.
Razor 8?
Yeah.
As in, you have 8 razors? Or?
I was born on 8 February.
That sucks.
That's a terrible name.
Come on.
Okay, I would love to get just Razor, mm-hmm. but it's not out there.
Mm-hmm. I had that problem with Musky Bad, too.
Yeah,
for sure. No, I'm just kidding. I didn't actually. I wanted to do Musky Bad with the 4, so I could be like hip and, you know, urban. God.
I would love to find who has Razor and just be like, yo, just give it to me. They probably don't even use it.
You never know.
You never know.
Maybe are just as eager to have Razor as you are. They probably count their blessings every day. Holy shit. Take a look at this team here. We've got Melise, who is a lovely young woman by the name of Kimochi. And she is a freaking beast on AD carry, dude. Yeah. She's actually monstrous. And then, of course, Mr. Mortified, huge in the fighting games community, one of the Toronto top tiers guys. Actually, the dude who helped me set up the stream. So, shout-outs to him.
Thank you very much, sir.
Holding it down on team. I'm not sure exactly what this team is because
so we have
they
Team Vaughn and Team Barry.
Team Barry, okay.
Just not sure which one is which.
The team on the left is Team Vaughn. They just played. Right. We just saw them play. Wrath is on that team as well, and they ran a Protect the Caitlyn composition, which went very well.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
They basically had the two hard carries on that team. Of course, are Danky Nugs and Wrath. Wrath is Diamond now. I don't think he was when he signed up. But regardless, they basically 2v5'd that game like monsters. And they are also the winners of the previous tournament.
Wow, that's ridiculous. Because the previous game I casted also had a Caitlyn. And she picked up 2 quadra kills in one game. She nearly had 2 pentas. But scumbag Ari died before the teamfight started.
What an asshole.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, I'll say, she died to a Veigar ultimate. There was nothing Caitlyn could do to get the kill.
Sure, sure.
But Yeah. Cool. What do you think about Caitlyn? Do you think she's coming back?
No. I don't know. She's a lane bully.
Yeah.
And always has been, always will be. She just doesn't compare to Trist and Jinx. She just doesn't, period.
No,
there's nothing
no.
to it.
What would you do to Caitlyn to get her back into the game then?
I would probably give her a... Maybe a steroid on
that's what I'm thinking.
Her ultimate or something like that, kind of similar to Sivir.
Mm-hmm.
Something like that. But her strength is her range. So
no, definitely.
She's a good lane bully. She's really good in the late game when she hits like 5-6 items because that's when abilities become pretty much useless and that's when you just auto-attack, right?
Yeah, for
and
sure.
She's really good at that point, but why would you play her when you can play Jinx? The only difference is that she has a escape, a net. And if you're running, you know, Morgana, Lulu, you don't really need that. You can just take AoE auto attacks instead. So,
yeah, for sure. Definitely, yeah. I definitely like Jinx a lot more than Caitlyn. I remember when she came out, spammed so much Jinx.
See, I actually like Caitlyn more. Personally, I think Caitlyn's more fun because I like the way that she plays in lane. I think there's a dominance to it that can't be underrated. I think it's just player specific. You know, it plays a little bit into their style because it allows Wrath to win lane even harder.
Yeah.
But the way Wrath plays, I don't think it would matter if he was playing, you know, Kog'Maw or Caitlyn. He'd still do the same thing.
Well, let's look at these teams, though, right? Blue team is 2 diamonds and 3 silvers.
Yep.
Whereas red team is 1 diamond, 2 plats, 1 gold, and 1 silver.
Yeah. So I would place the plat 4 of Melee's as a diamond AD carry, though. She's very, very, very good.
That's some confidence there.
Yeah, okay. She's freaking sick, man. Like, I pride myself on my Shaco and being able to 1v1 and outplaying people.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember playing against her at the Toronto League Commune Social.
Okay.
And she just freaking dumped me. Like, 6-7 times she just outplayed me in a 1v1. And I was pretty damn impressed. And she's been to a lot of these tournaments. I don't think she's ever won one, but she's a freaking beast. Actually, no, she did win one with Mr. Mortified, actually. They did win one of these tournaments as well, now that I think about it. So this is actually two teams.
So that
teams.
Would be like a duo queue?
Happened to be. No,
oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. I was speaking to him yesterday about this. It just happened to be on the same team again.
Mm-hmm.
So 2 previous winners on both these teams.
Why not? Let's see what happens here. Now, is this a single elimination, or how's
it's a group stage? So
group stage?
The teams are playing against each other, and then it's the top win record will move on.
All right. So this is my first solo queue tournament, but I know you've had some experience here. You are actually a winner as well, I believe.
Yeah. So there's a difference in the solo queue legends and the solo queue hero. Solo queue legends is the one that is held at George Brown, and it's massive. It's we've got over 100 players here. And the one that I won was a little bit smaller. It was held at Happy Turbo Cafe.
Okay, yeah.
A little bit smaller. Still the same premise, though. And I did win.
So you're not a big winner, is what you're saying.
Exactly, because unfortunately I had to cast all these ones.
Oh, but unfortunately?
Unfortunately. I want to win the money, man. I want to win the pride as well.
There is that. I love tournaments, and I love casting them. I love organizing them.
Yeah.
But there is just a different vibe about playing in them.
Yeah, man. You feel like a badass. Honestly, winning
when
that tournament was probably one of the best days of my life just because of the way the whole day went. We didn't have the best team in terms of ELO or anything like that. We didn't have our highest player was a Diamond 5.
Mm-hmm.
And we lost – I don't think we lost a single inhibitor the entire tournament.
Wow, okay.
And we just dumped on people, and it was all shot calling. Even if we would lose early game, we had really good draft phases where we would just have – really intricate team comps. This was like when I was playing Gragas as a jungler before Gragas started getting played, and I was playing him like AP with like Poke in the mid with Jason, Xerath. We just had really, really cool comps going on, and that's why I really think that understanding a comp, drafting something that has good synergy together, and having a strong shot caller, as long as your teams aren't getting demolished and you're not going like 0-7 in lane, anyone can win.
Yeah, for sure. Drafting is something a lot of teams ignore. Especially when you're not like a solid team, right? It's just like, whatever, I'll play a champ I'm good at.
Yeah.
But drafting is extremely important.
Mm-hmm.
You can draft an easy to play comp, play with random people and still win. You could go for wombos if you think your team can pull that off. A lot of teams ignore that, and they just kind of like, oh, you know, I'll just play Jinx because I'm good at Jinx. I'll just play Xerath because I'm good at Xerath.
Absolutely. That's the difference between solo queue players and team players.
Of course.
Right? Like, if you have team experience coming into this tournament, then you know these things. If you're a very proactive leader, you get your team names, you get their champion pools, and you start a Google Doc, and you start breaking stuff down. And with $1,500 on the line...
For sure, that's a lot of
why
money.
Why wouldn't you,
why
right?
not? That's, so, how are the prizes being distributed?
I think it's winner take all.
Oh, wow.
Might be first and second place. Might be like $1,000 to first place, $500 to second place.
Hey, that's still $200 a pop. That's
pretty sexy shit.
That's half of my PS4. Yeah, I'd like that.
There you go.
Or maybe a new monitor. I could use a new monitor.
Yeah, when I won the tournament, I think I got like $80, but I was just like, yeah, like,
hey, free money is
free. It was so much fun, dude. We had a party afterwards as well. All the guys came. It was freaking, it was a good time. It was super fun.
Musky Bad likes winning.
I love winning.
Everyone loves winning.
I love winning.
I remember the first tournament I won was actually a UTLA tournament. It was one of our first tournaments, I believe. It was the ARAM tournament in second year. Getting that triumphant rise. When you select that in-game, people are like, oh, this guy's good at this game. I'm shit at Ryze. I have no idea how to play him.
I want to do an all-for-one with Ryze, with Triumphant Ryze skins. 5 Triumphant Ryze skins.
That is a brilliant
idea.
That
would be ballin'. That would be my jam.
You know what? Let's do that. All right. Do you have the skin?
I just won the solo queue hero tournament. Of course
I'm
I got
sorry.
The skin.
I'm sorry.
Bruh.
All right. We should... We need 3 more Triumphant Ryze players out there. So if anyone wants to play, you
maybe we'll get some of the guys from this team.
Hopefully.
Look at Kamal in the background here.
Why are you stalking him? Look at that beautiful smile right there.
That's hilarious.
That is great.
Good look.
All right. Sorry, guys. I'm normally asleep right now. As most of us are.
Noon?
Yeah.
I've been trying to get up a little bit earlier, but...
I've been trying. Yeah. I've been told that I need to wake up before 2 p.m. And I think that's a good idea. I just think it takes way too much work.
Yeah. That's too... That's, you know, 21st century thinking.
Yeah.
We're ahead of everybody else. I'm just planning for when the sun is gone, you know?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yep. So we're having the hardest time for these people to switch sides. I'm going to give them a threatening message. Switch sides quickly. Get ready to play or both teams are eliminated.
Wow, Jackson dropping
you
the hammer
one
there.
1 minute. Not really. Let's go, though.
All right. We have reset this timer a few times, but I think we got rid of it now.
Yeah.
Looks like we should be good soon.
Yep. This is going to be an interesting breakdown because Meili's obviously the person. I don't know Batman's bread. I've never seen him play before. But obviously he's the highest rated. He's 200 something games on. Interesting. They're switching up their pick ban order. So it looks like. I wonder if Batman's. Okay, so Batman bread is going to be second pick, which makes me think that he's the jungler or at least that he's got more champions to pick from. Mm-hmm. I think that's probably what it is, actually. But he's Diamond 3. He's got 260 wins in ranked. Diamond
that's
3.
That's really good. Diamond 3 on 260 wins is, you know.
It's not bad.
It's not bad.
Better than me. the thing that's crucial here is that I'm actually really interested to see how these bans go down. But Meili's is the player who I know the most and who I would trust the most to go against Wrath. And unless we see a different style coming out from Team Vaughn here, they most likely are going to go for a Lulu top and just a strong AD carry that can like kind of 1v5, like the Jinx, like the Caitlyn in the late game. Meili's might be able to win late. They ban Soraka and they ban Twisted Fate. I imagine that the Twisted Fate is probably Batman's bread. I don't think they'd waste a ban elsewise. Mm-hmm. However, the mid laner of this Vaughn team did struggle last time. He got pretty pooped on, to be honest, by the Zed as a Cassiopeia. I like this first pick. I think Tristana is really strong in pretty much any matchup. However, Tom Kench is picked
Trist
up first.
A safe pick. You just sit back, farm.
She's very strong.
Yeah, like
also, can push the game forward very quickly. Udyr going to go to the jungle again. It seems like that's pretty much all Nasty Joe can really play, at this point at least. But the thing is, if they're going for that late-game AD carry composition, then if you pick Tristan, you rotate the lanes and everything like that, you can get it out of lane phase. You can turn it into a very fast game. Usually that will happen with lane swaps, but Tristana, if she's got a good matchup, she can do that as well. Like, you know, something like, I don't know, Lulu, Tristana, bottom, that's a lot of wave clear. They can just hit that tower over and over and over and over again. Speaking of which, Lulu is up. That could be a lot of protection for the purple team if they decide to go for that.
Well, here's one thing I want to talk about. Blue team bans look very standard. Mordekaiser, Darius, Gangplank.
Yep.
So are they not respecting the enemy team? What's going on here? Because the other team, Soraka, Twisted Fate, Jinx,
looks
like those are respect bans.
That the Lulu would have been the real ban that I'm surprised wasn't there. Maybe they're more comfortable dealing with that style of composition than having, you know, Danky Nugs on a Gangplank instead. You know what I mean? They'd rather just deal with that one threat as opposed to both. However, that Tahm Kench could be top lane. Top lane Tahm Kench is actually pretty good.
He's just very tanky.
The Xin Zhao and the Lee Sin are very hard to deal with as an AD carry.
Oh, wow. I just noticed that.
Especially if they go with, like, a Yasuo. Maybe, like, Yasuo and Rumble or something like that. That'd be pretty much domination of the AD carry. However, don't forget, they got Tahm Kench, who's always picking
him
up.
Well, see, here's what I'm thinking. Lee Sin is jungling?
Yep.
And Xin Zhao's top lane?
You're right.
So...
You're right.
So, yeah, you know, like, what's going on there? I would personally put Xin Zhao in the jungle.
Caitlyn again.
I don't think Lee Sin... I don't think Xin Zhao is such a strong laner. I don't know. What do you think about that?
I agree. But it's one of those champions that Silvers like to play. And that might be their champion.
Well, he's easy to execute,
player.
Right? Yeah. I've played a lot of Xin Zhao jungle. You have no skill shots.
Yeah.
You jump on someone, you queue him a bit, get that Devourer damage, and they're done.
It's true. Okay.
Syndra.
Interesting.
Pink. Okay.
So.
Syndra to LeBlanc.
I like the idea. That's a fine matchup. I think it's okay. As long as you get your stun onto LeBlanc, you win. You have a lot shorter cooldowns than LeBlanc does, all apart from your ultimate. Okay. So I think that's going to be a LeBlanc support.
No, Tahm has to be supporting. LeBlanc mid, Zed top?
I would think Zed mid, but it looks like they are going to put him. Yeah, so I guess they're running Zed top against a Xin Zhao. Interesting. Not sure how that matchup goes. Just bizarre picks on both sides, to be honest. So on the side of Team Barry, I think that Syndra is an okay idea. However, against Tahm Kench, you just eat the person getting ulted if you have reaction times quick enough. It's pretty much a pick comp. It's like a siege comp slash pick kind of just run at their face comp. We saw a lot of weakness actually coming here from Tahm or from Team Vaughn last game with their vision control. It wasn't the best. Obviously, a lot of their attention is focused towards just those two guys on the team. They've got Wrath and they've got Danky Nugs. Those are their two carries, and they're focused on getting gold. They're not focused on warding and stuff like that. They just want to get their items to carry, and that actually leaves a pretty big hole in it is.
Yeah.
It leaves a pretty big hole in their strategy, however. So we'll have to see what happens. Mr. Mortified on that Thresh, if he can control vision just like the other team did, and they did a really good job at finding picks. There isn't a great front line on this comp from Team Vaughn because they do have that Udyr, who last time we saw him play actually felt pretty far behind, and the only reason he was relevant was because there was a Lulu.
Oh, okay, I see what you're saying.
So, interesting things here.
Well, Tom's going to be extremely tanky if he builds right.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So you have the Tahm Kench front line.
However, the thing that we noticed last game, actually, I guess it's different this time, but with Danky Nugs on Lulu, they had to focus on getting the Harbinger very early. Mm-hmm. Tahm Kench can't do that this game.
No.
So they're going to need to rely a lot more on Danky Nugs to be a split pusher. And if he doesn't do well in lane against Batman's Bread, who is taking Ignite in the top lane, he wants to just go 1v1 as hard as he can. No TP there. I could be LeBlanc top. I think that makes no sense.
No. You want
if Batman's Bread wins that lane, Danky Nugs is in big trouble. They're going to have a hard time winning this game. They need that Zed to be able to split push.
Well, here's what I'm thinking. Zed versus Xin Zhao. Early game, If Zed can land his skill shots, yeah, he's got the advantage. Post 6, Zed can't ult on him.
Yeah.
But a smart Xin Zhao would just drop his ultimate right away.
You're right.
And throw him off.
Mm-hmm.
And then re-engage later. You can dash in with your E and wait for him to come close to you, Q him, whatever you can do.
It's going
to
be so hard for Udyr to get into.
Skill matchup.
Like, there's... Uder's
yeah, the
be Uder, like,
I'm not feeling the Uder. She's just not fitting in with the team. What?
I feel almost like Uder should go Frozen Mallet and just kill the front line.
Frozen Mallet?
Yeah. Like,
I'm thinking Frozen Heart. You want to stop the
Yeah,
Chris.
For sure.
You
but
drop Xin Zhao.
I don't think he's going to be able to get in, though, because they have the slow from the box, right?
Oh, yeah, that's
they've got
what I'm
the
saying.
CC just from Thresh, and then they've got the knockback from the Syndra. He's not going to be able to get in the back line. I feel like he should just try and
no,
peel for Wrath.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we want. The Frozen Heart to reduce their attack speed so
sure.
they don't
Xin Zhao, actually, yeah, does it focus a lot on attack speed.
Yeah, so you want the Frozen Heart. I would even go Randuin's and Frozen Heart. Because Syndra ult, they have an answer, which is Tahm Kench Ichu, right? But you can only keep someone inside you for so long. Xin Zhao's going to get on you. Tristan's going to get on you. You want the attack speed reduction.
Very interesting compositions.
Yeah. I'm really confused about the LeBlanc teleport, though, because you want to have Ignite.
Yeah.
You want that kill pressure early game.
I think I get Blem out there is going to probably lose lane again. Just based off the way that I saw him play, he got pooped on pretty hard. and Syndra is a good matchup in a LeBlanc. So, and if you pick that into LeBlanc, then you know what you're doing.
If Syndra is skilled.
Yes.
Yes.
I do imagine that he is, though.
Yeah.
Jackson I think he was the second plat.
Faith. Okay.
So I will change the team names. Oops.
All right. Let's take a look here. So, yeah, teams look fairly balanced. There's a lot of skill on this LeBlanc. She is Mastery 5, whereas Syndra isn't. So maybe she's got something up her sleeve.
Potentially.
Yeah. And as soon as we get into the game, we have a pause.
Yeah,
all right, let's talk
like to see.
Level 1 invades. What are you seeing here?
Thresh and I guess Thresh is really the only thing. LeBlanc
well,
can take chain if she wants.
If Thresh gets his hook, Xin can knock them up. On the other side, we do have Tom's like Q, his tongue.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just a slow. That's all it is. Definitely play 5-man ward defend your own jungle as red team.
So, with this pause, I guess we can break it down for those guys that are out there in Twitch land. Of course, this is the second game of the day of the Solo Queue Legends tournament. Solo Queue Legends number 3. We got $1,500 on the line here, and basically the idea for the Solo Queue Legends tournament is to get a whole bunch of people from Toronto, get them to sign up, doesn't matter what their elo is, put them on a team that's relatively similar in skill and, you know, who should technically be even in terms of a win-loss kind of setup, and see who comes out on top. A lot of the game is focused around leadership and vision control and just how you work as a team. It's a really unique and interesting style of tournament that is a lot of fun to both participate in and watch because the storylines are very cool.
The storyline. Yeah, no, it's great because you know, there's a lot of players who are lower elo, but they like the competition. And if you go into a regular tournament, you run into extremely high elo players. What this does is gives you a chance. You might be silver 1, but you might have a diamond with you who can teach you something, who can help you improve. And that might be all the difference that you need to kind of win a competition.
For sure.
And I've definitely been there. I started off season 1 as unranked. And I've learned a lot, and a lot of it has been from tournaments, playing with more skilled players, and they teach you stuff, and you look at them like, oh, okay, that's what you do.
Yeah.
You don't ward, sorry, you don't face check bushes.
I remember hearing a very funny story from one of my friends who was filling for somebody in the tournament. He was playing with a diamond. He was like, you know, pretty much only played Ashe and Soraka.
Okay.
And he wound up being a Soraka bot and just following around the diamond the whole game, just healing him, healing, healing, healing. And they won, apparently. But there's whole different ways you can play this game.
It's hey, that's awesome. Amusing. Soraka's the new ambulance, right?
Yep.
Her passive is so much fun to just run around with.
Yeah,
ridiculous
totally
amount of move speed.
Looks like we're having some very interesting discussion going on here.
What's going on?
Nothing really interesting, actually. I lied. Some boring stuff, in fact.
All right, so what do you think? Double jungle? No double jungle?
Probably a double jungle. We did see a double jungle come out from the Team Vaughn last time. I assume that, obviously, Batman's being that diamond player. It is typical for the double jungle to go down in diamond. So
well, but Batman
that.
Does have teleport.
That's true. Good point.
And
so
neither does
probably
Yankee
not,
Nates.
Then.
Well,
you're so smart.
Well, no. See, this is what I'm thinking. If they do have the ignite, they have kill pressure. You quickly get your buff, and you invade. Mm-hmm. You could, Lee Sin Xin Zhao can definitely destroy an Uder early game. There's nothing Uder can do. What's he going to do?
Yeah.
Bear stance his way out.
That's such a dominant 2v2.
Yeah, no, it's ridiculous. You have so much CC between the two of them, especially post 6. And the knock-up and the slow again off of Xin Zhao. You're not getting out of there if you're Uder. And I really want to know where LeBlanc is going. Because LeBlanc versus Xin Zhao is going to be an interesting lane as well. Sit back, poke.
Yeah, she's definitely going to go mid. Danky Nugs is definitely playing top.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Interesting that they both picked Ignite.
Yeah.
Is that something...
I guess they just want to throw down. You know?
Yeah, they just want to
open
their
lane. It's a gentleman's agreement, and they were like, yo, man, I'll take Ignite if you take Ignite.
I've seen a lot of diamonds in tournaments like this take Ignite, though, because they want to win their lane and use that advantage rather than TP and make plays.
There you go. Well, I mean, it's a high-level lane for sure. These are two diamond players, right?
Yeah, I guess they're doing the whole I'll win my lane by brute force and carry my team from there. And as, you know, that's an okay strategy, but coming from, like, a more team-oriented background where, like, I'll pick up a Moomoo if I have to, or I will play...
I love Moomoo, dude. AP Moomoo? That's my jam.
AP Moomoo is the cancer that is spreading through solo queue right now.
Is it really?
You don't see anything, and you get bandaged, that's half your health. You get ulted, and you're like, all right, you know what? I'm the one crying tears.
Playing against squishy comms, you pick AP Amumu and you one-shot their team.
It's ridiculous. Hilarious. How's that even allowed? Riot needs to fix these champions.
I didn't realize that people actually played AP Amumu. That was like my secret weapon.
It's becoming a thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Shit, dude.
And pure AP. These guys go the Sheen upgrade.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Which is stupid. You barely auto-attack as Amumu.
You get like one passive, auto. Your passive reduces their MR.
It reduces MR.
So
you get like
so you
one
want
auto
attack. Yeah, you want it.
Yeah, but it's you get than, it's one or two auto attacks.
I like going for the double pen, obviously. Haunting guys and Sork boots into either Zonya's or Rylai's.
No, I've seen people go
just straight
Sheen item.
That's terrible. That's
Rylai's
actually really
and decap.
Bad. That's
no, because
really Rylai's,
you bandage
it,
and they're done. Yeah. That's it. You have the one-to-one scaling on so many of his abilities.
I love Amumu, dude. I love Amumu.
I definitely love Amumu.
I'm outie, dude.
I've got a lot of skins on him, too. It's, he's a great champion, but I just like the whole, you're tanking, but you're doing so much damage with your tears. You're literally killing these people by crying on them.
Yep.
The concept is great.
I actually maxed the tears last.
Really?
Yep.
You get stunned before? Doesn't increase the duration.
Reduces cooldown.
Yeah, I guess. If you're good enough, you only need to land one.
What are you talking about? I kill
like
four people.
You only land one.
Oh my gosh. This is some interesting gameplay going on here. Gotta say. This is
The pause gameplay? They're mind tricking each other.
They are.
First person to give up and run away.
Yeah, our stream overlord Tony has actually left to go to George Brown to see what the frick is going on.
We're really close to George Brown, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Like 2 minutes away.
Yeah.
I almost just want to like play YouTube videos for the stream or something.
Show them our world's highlight from last year. We are having a world's final viewing party.
Yep.
When is that? October 31st at 10?
It's actually
10,
when 8? Worlds is,
surprisingly enough. No, I'm thinking about the timing. Is it 8 a.m., 10 8 in the morning?
Early.
It is early. All right, we are back in game. Woo. Champion's finally spawning.
Hooray. I'm honest. I'm done with this game. I already know. I feel like I've already watched it play out already.
Yeah? All right.
Yeah.
Who's winning?
Red team.
Red team?
I actually based off the way that Wrath played last game, they've got a good chance. Danky Nugs, obviously, on Zed, able to carry a little bit harder. However, they've matched the two strongest lanes for Team Vaughn. They've got their Diamond in the top lane, and they've got melees in the bottom lane. I feel like it could be even. It's like both teams are crossing. They definitely did see each other, though.
Did they? I don't think so.
I thought they did.
No, they definitely didn't.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
I thought I saw a ping come down. Guess not.
Nope.
We might see a return then. If they go down into that bush, we could see a full 5-on-5, which would be nuts.
No, I think they...
Somebody's probably going to go base, though. I bet you the Xin Zhao is going to go base.
It would be smart for him to go to base just to get to lane on time, but I think they're aware that the other team
could be a lane swap.
Invading.
Could definitely be a lane swap.
Lane swap wouldn't benefit. Well, it would benefit Trist somewhat. Early game, just farm.
It would hurt the Zed and the Xin Zhao more than anything.
Oh yeah, it would definitely.
All right, here we go. Danky Nugs does actually spot out that Syndra.
It's interesting. So, blue team is in no position to start their jungle now. They are gonna have a delayed start.
Yeah. Wrath trying to do Gromp with his buddy Tom Kenshi. They will be able to get that. They will be able to get the early level 2 bottom lane.
Alright, so.
And on the flip side, obviously, they didn't push early, so it shouldn't be punished at all. That's a pretty big advantage right off the get go, and they only miss one minion.
Do you notice something? LeBlanc is double jungling. Yeah, so it's interesting. Xin Zhao is pushing top.
Bizarre.
It's you know.
Bizarre. Why?
Some strat, I guess.
That's like the worst matchup of all time.
Yeah, but Xin Zhao's doing the smart thing. Dude, a lot of people do not.
This LeBlanc
push.
Is actually gonna miss so much.
Well, that's what you have to do when they lane swap. You push when they double jungle. You push really hard, and you deny them all that golden experience. Getting some aggression bot lane.
The early level 2 we were talking about, and a huge minion wave pumping into Mr. Mortified. Woo! Spicy.
As your friend likes to say, habanero. Spicy.
Does
habanero.
He say that?
Yeah.
That's awful.
Simo? Simo's a great guy.
Yeah, but that's an awful thing to say.
Zed getting some good damage onto Syndra.
See, that's the thing. Lee Solaire, I think that's probably why they put Duncan on Dunsmith. Because they didn't have to put him against the Diamond. They don't really care what the LeBlanc does because he's probably going to lose either way.
Yeah, so LeBlanc with Teleport doesn't have that much kill pressure, right? That's it. And Xin Zhao can sustain her poke. Whereas Syndra doesn't have anything to heal her against the Zed. So, wow. Being pretty ballsy, invading the jungle as Xin Zhao levels.
He might go for a gank here, which might get actually countered by the Lee Sin, which would be hilarious. Or maybe he will be the one countering. If he does land on Danky Nugs, he'll be okay with a quick 1-2.
It's interesting. Bot lane is getting pushed in. You'd imagine that Triss would push harder, but this Caitlyn's really dropping damage onto them. Excuse me. Syndra dropping those autos when she can't get some harass onto Zed. And Triss finally pushing her lane. Looter sitting in the top brush, hoping to see
Xin Zhao. Just wasting time.
Yeah, this is not the best use of his time. He could definitely do something.
Xin Zhao, honestly.
Lee Sin with a great Q onto Zed. Not much follow up from Syndra right there. But everything helps. Triss dropping some damage onto Caitlyn with the explosion. Not much follow-up there. Looks like Tom was walking away for some reason, not helping her. All in all, very tight. good aggression here from Xin Zhao, but answered back by the chain to the Monk.
Yeah, so this game so far is pretty much just about the lanes, and it does seem like Danky Nugs and Wrath both have an advantage here. I would say Wrath... It's really hard to say which way this lane is going to go in the bottom lane, to be honest. It's,
well, the farm is equal.
Yeah, but I mean in terms of, like, if it goes even, who's going to come out more on top? Like, if it goes even, what matters more? Because both lanes can't really be killed. They both have insane escapes. You know, the lantern, the swallow, whatever you want to call it, being eaten by Tom Kench.
Devour.
Yes. There you go.
Yeah. Okay, so this is my thought process. Trist has steroids. In a straight up 1v1, if they have the same items, Trist is going to win. No problem. But Caitlyn's dropping a world of hurt on these guys, and she might actually be going for the kill on this Thresh. Really low, drops it. Pacemaker, but just more aggression mid lane. Zed nearly getting the kill. Oh, gets First Blood on to Syndra. Wow, the Ignite really paid off there, didn't it? Udyr going in for Lee Sin, but Lee Sin might have some moves up his sleeve. Udyr does get the knockup. Looks like an easy kill for him.
Yep. And no assist for Zed, unfortunately.
Two very clean kills, though, for Red Team.
That's a big deal, getting the kill onto Zed. Syndra went with the aggressive summoner spell. I think she probably expected...
Xin Zhao going aggressive onto LeBlanc, showing her who has top lane dominance. That is why you do not go on top.
So that's what I mean, though. This game is really just like the lanes that we kind of thought would win are winning.
Wow, Xin Zhao flashing in there. LeBlanc trying to do something, but she might get the kill. No, none of them die. Udyr is on to Xin Zhao right now, but he might not be able to catch her.
Yeah, Zim with no summoners as well. Udyr does have flash. He could flash the wall here, try and catch up to him with the stun. He's going for the bear form, getting the move speed. Doesn't look like he will commit, though.
No, so that was interesting. Double Doran Xin Zhao, diving the LeBlanc. And Caitlyn going aggressive onto Trist right now, at least in there to stop the engage, though.
Yeah, unfortunately, that wasn't the best gank. Could have gone for a Lantern or something like that. Just a Mortified Force to flash out. It was basically just a very slow lane game with not a lot of high-level play happening, basically. This looks like your epitome of a solo queue game.
Udyr going in for Xin Zhao. Looks like he stuns the wrong character. Goes on a minion. Xin Zhao does still die to ridiculous damage from Tiger Stance.
I wonder how it feels to be a Diamond player getting killed by a Silver Udyr.
That could have been a lot more cleaner, though.
Oh,
he,
sure.
He stunned a minion.
Yeah.
And he only got the kill because of the smite and the Tiger Stance. Xin Zhao nearly was at it, and with a kill, too.
2-0 Udyr this time around. I think he's going for that Devourer, or he's going for the Warrior. All right.
So Zed going in for Syndra, drops the ultimate, should have the death on her, but will this be a
double kill for him?
Whoa!
Not quite. Almost, though.
Very close there.
Yeah, he did get his passive off onto the Lee Sin, but...
Yeah, if Lee Sin didn't have his ultimate there, that was it.
Yeah.
And again, if Lee Sin might have ulted earlier, he could have possibly saved Syndra. I think he got some greed there, maybe. Wanted to kill for himself? Not sure what happened there. Lee Sin was being very dominant in the early game, wasn't he? He's definitely ganked a lot more than Udyr. Udyr just been lucky, I guess. What do you think?
Well, Udyr, you know, has capitalized on the obscene overconfidence of XX Batman's Bread XX on that Xin Zhao. And you know, when you see somebody on a Xin Zhao top lane...
Alright, like, 4-man gank bot lane. Trist is just going to jump out. Looks like he won't be able to do much. Dropping a lot of damage onto Trist. Udyr flashes in, gets the kill with Tiger Stance. Does drop to Tristana. That was interesting. I think they were going for a dragon there, maybe, to get bot kills. What do you think?
I think they just want to get Wrath ahead. That's pretty much their goal. Wrath is probably like, we can die this guy, we can die this guy. And that is exactly what they do. Also, pulling them away from the mid lane, giving Danky Nugs the opportunity to 1v1 and outplay that Syndra is massive. You can see he's already building up towards that TMF. Look at that damage coming out.
Wow, that is that's a lot of damage coming off of Zed in 10 minutes.
LeBlanc does TP down. does get in trouble as well by doing that. She will lose her tower.
But they have an answer.
They do have an answer. Probably go for Dragon after this. But, you know, opening up that tower for the Xin Zhao top, he could very well become a big split push threat later on in the game.
Yeah, so I can definitely see them seeing. And there it is. They're stealing Uder's jungle. That might have been why Uder went to Warrior. Perhaps he feared some retribution from Xin Zhao?
Yeah.
And
going for somewhat of a... I'm not really understanding it. I mean, you would want a tank regardless. It doesn't matter. Here we go with the engage.
Xin Zhao going a bit ballsy. Gets a lot of damage off of Caitlyn. Fresh lands a hook. Lee Sin and Xin Zhao force them back, but Uder will be there to pick up the kill. LeBlanc gets the kill, and that is a double kill onto Xin Zhao and Lee Sin. Chris still going extremely hard. Uder going in for the chase, but a great knockback from Syndra stops the engage. This could really go anyway. Syndra does have a lot of damage to dish out right now, but looks like they might just try to run away. No tower for them, so this fight might still go on. Goes on to Caitlyn, drops the ultimate, but will that be enough? Thresh in a really sticky position here. There's no getting out for him. And Syndra might be falling next. Trist really low. Everyone's just in a horrible position right now. Syndra going to be the next one to fall. And easy stun from Uder. Looks like they might want to give the kill to LeBlanc, and that was it there.
Honestly, this game, just a whole lot of really bad decision making from the blue team, sadly. And the red team just coming ahead after every single play.
Lee Sin going in for the kick. Easy kill for him. Will he be able to make more out of this, though? Caitlyn does have no mana, but Xin Zhao left. Xin Zhao going on to the Tom Kench. Good flash there. Gets him out of there.
Yeah, Xin could have flashed as well, but he chose to save it. Felt like it wasn't worth it. Wanted to get the dragon instead. Top lane, there's a massive wave that's going to be hitting that tower, and that's going to be a lot of missed experience if they don't get in up there quickly, which might be part of the reason why they are heading off of this dragon.
Yeah, so that could have been an easy dragon for them. What do you think? Dragon?
Yeah,
you know, five people advantage rather than just experience this in jail?
It would have been their first dragon. I guess I don't really know how this blue team's going to win, to be honest. I think the only way that they're going to win is with picks, with the Thresh and the Syndra. They didn't really have any setup for the dragon, so maybe that's why they wanted to avoid that fight. They're probably just going to get, you know, out skirmished right now by this team with like four assassins, basically, or three assassins and a Tom Kench. can't really count Caitlyn as an assassin.
Not yet.
I think that's an AP Xin Zhao.
Is? Oh my god. He's just dropping the BM there. Some confidence coming. Or he's given up.
This is AP Xin Zhao, so he's actually going to be wanting to team fight more than split push, actually.
Yeah. Good dragon pickup. The assassin was farming top. No man on Syndra. Huh. LeBlanc going in there for a bit of poke. She doesn't have the damage to kill her. Where's item Morello's?
Yeah, I mean, it'll reduce the healing. Coming up from the AP Xin Zhao.
I guess. But you want to go for that first AP. Get a loot and even get a decap if you want. It's going to reduce her damage output for sure, but her team's ahead enough. They don't need the assassin right now. They have that in Zed. Uder fairly fed as well.
Like to see some vision control coming up from Team Barry here. You can see Mr. Morphe trying to clear some pings, trying to do something for his team, but he needs to get his own wards down as well. You can see he's actually got none. He needs to go base, he needs to get some wards, buy some pings, and start dropping things so he can control vision across the map, because right now he really has no idea when LeBlanc is going to pop over wall and try to pick, same as Zed.
And this LeBlanc is being ballsy with her plays.
Don't forget,
she's gone in multiple times and just dashed back out.
There is the TP as well, so you can see a Tom Kench pick somebody up, go down, drop a ward. There's deep pressure in this game, which cannot really be answered by that opposing team.
Caitlyn slowly pulling ahead of Tristana right now. She does have the range. She's got some more farm, about 10-20 farm more. And
I honestly don't like the decision from this red
Wow, Thresh finally lands a hook onto LeBlanc. Gets devoured by Tahmkent, saving LeBlanc and disengaging on that fight. That was a very dead LeBlanc there.
Yeah, that's why I said Tahmkent. I don't like the decision from this red team.
Thresh gets another hook onto Zed. Zed nearly dies. Tahm saving her again. A lot of damage onto Lee Sin, but blue team looking for the engage here. So many people so low in this fight. Thresh gets another hook, but Caitlyn gets a beautiful pacemaker and gets the kill. Going further, tower dive, ace in the hole, blocked by Tristana. Wow. A lot of damage from Caitlyn right there.
Yeah, just basically they're freaking way far ahead. They've gotten all their items completed. Whereas you look at the opposing team, they still haven't finished. No one on their team has finished an item yet. But you look at the opposing team, they've all finished items. They've got, you know, very strong builds. Everyone down the line, especially that Caitlyn, having those boots too, with all that AD is very, very strong as opposed to what Tristana has right now.
Yeah.
Basically just got walked over, forced into a fight. I mean, it was good for them to force that power spike. However, at the same time, I don't know if they group up in the future, if it will work as well. You saw like two free hooks come down. They're more of a skirmish comp. You know, they don't have a tanky shooter yet. He's working on it. They could get picked off very easily, to be honest.
Yeah, for sure. But those were really good hooks off Thresh. He landed three hooks in a row.
Yep.
And they still couldn't do anything.
Yeah.
Well,
literally just because those items, they were fighting on items that were not completed yet.
Yeah. But, you know, like, the only item Caitlyn had on Trist was the boots. And that made enough of a difference. Even with her attack speed stored, it's
very early game for Caitlyn right now. It's in the like as soon as the Infinity Edge is finished and she does start building towards, you know, the seal, that's when she's going to start falling off. But right now, that was like her huge power spike. Having that AD and then just having the mobility and the attack speed to get more procs on her fast.
Oh yeah,
she just spiked really hard, especially compared to Tristana, who really doesn't have that much damage at that point. Let's see if Wrath can make another outplay here. Gets a flash, avoids the slow from melees and the play. Walk right on out of there.
And they don't want to follow that. Because of lack of vision, they don't know who's there.
TP, Tahmkent.
Yeah. That's exactly what you were mentioning about the vision, though, as well. They don't know where anyone is, and they just backed off. They could have built that. Definitely had the abilities to chase that.
Well, that's the thing, too, right? For them to win with this comp, they need the vision so that they can get those picks in the first place.
Yeah, for sure. No, definitely. Red team clearly dominated in vision and gold and items and strategy. This is looking bad and bad for blue team right now.
Yeah, they are down 6,000 gold at the 17-minute mark. That is massive.
Yeah,
I want to take a look at the gold really quick. It is, let's take a look really quick. About 1,000 gold on each of the laners. The only one who's really not getting smashed is the Xin Zhao. And that's more because the LeBlanc has had quite a few opportunities to farm this game.
Yeah, so LeBlanc's doing a lot more roaming than Xin. And it's paying off. That teleport, you know, she got. It's working. It's surprising, but it's working.
Alright, we might just see another engage coming from the red team. They don't really care about their comp style anymore. They just kind of want to run at each other.
Well, they're ahead enough to do that.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of engage. Like, those hooks from Mr. Mortified were kind of engaging for his team. Mm-hmm. Even though he was landing good hooks, they weren't able to capitalize on them because they didn't have the items. So he was really just engaging for them. You know, I think the time that they went in was when they did find an ult onto Zed, and he just, you know, presses R and then walks away.
Looks like they are setting up for the next dragon in
They still don't have their item. They still don't have their items.
No, they don't. If they were to contest this, that would be...
They need to be trading. Look at top lane. Xin Zhao should be up there pushing that. Tristana should be pushing bottom. They need to be trading. Tristana can take down mid tower. She's Tristana.
Yeah,
they should not be fighting. Look at the item difference. If we skill up the dragon, it's only the second one. This is a very, very, very bad decision by whoever the shock caller is.
Might try to go in for the steal there. He does get the steal. Xin Zhao goes into the backline. Caitlyn dropping some damage from far away. Nearly gets destroyed. Xin Zhao drops an ult, but does not have enough damage. Xin Zhao going back in there. This is just looking bad and bad. Caitlyn dropping more Qs, just getting kills and kills. Drops the BM ace in the hole. Wow.
Pretty mechanically cooler fight, to be honest, from the side of the red team. There was some kills that definitely could have been avoided by better Tahm Kench usage. No exhaust used by Mr. Mortified, unfortunately. Heal not used by Tristana. All around, a sloppy fight. Went better than I expected, to be honest.
Yeah, no, Leeson definitely got the dragon. I think they were way too focused on dragon to care about the champion. And once they got dragon, they were like, okay, well, what do we do now? And Caitlyn had destroyed half of them by then.
Wrath two levels ahead of that Tristana. So strong right now.
And you know, Trist suffers from a mid-game weakness.
Nice. Wow. What a play. Or, what a net. Sorry. It was a good play.
It was a good play, but a good net
over the wall. Not the direction you expected him to go.
There's a lot of interesting things you can do with Caitlyn's net. I've seen a lot of people engage in fights too.
Yeah, sure.
Going for the mid-tower seat, this is what they should have been.
I actually hate Caitlyn's net because you can interrupt it with so many abilities, unlike other ones. Like, you can't Caitlyn net a Blitzcrank like you can with Tristana. You can't Caitlyn net a Leona like you can with Ezreal or Tristana or anything like that. It's kind of lame.
Hey, she needs to have some weakness. Come on.
So what's the weakness of Tristana then? Just that she pushes.
Tristana's weakness is she pushes really hard early game. That could be like played against.
That's like a positive as a weakness at the same time. Regardless, they have left open a pretty big opportunity for the team of Team Bond here. They are going to potentially just force down this tower. Look at that crit damage. He's got two items. He's hitting hard. He's also got support from his team here. And he's able to brute force that down. Unfortunately, no real clear opportunity to engage here. They want those picks, but they're so far behind. Leeson could follow that and try and get a big ultimate on the team, but obviously doesn't have his flash. That would be very difficult. They have to use. They might try and do
this
something here.
This is a bad place to be in if you are ready. Wow, just destroyed Leeson right there. And Tahm saves Scooter. Zed going into the backline. Gets ulted by Syndra. Does get the shutdown on Sindao. Thresh lands another hook, but not much follow-up there.
Yeah, no damage without that Tristana. Not sure exactly how Sinzao's gonna, you know, play into these team fights, to be honest.
Hey, they got Zed, and they got Caitlyn.
That was mostly the Syndra, though, honestly. Just the stun and the ult, just the
That's fine. They got the shared gold. And,
sure. I'm just saying, overall, I don't think Sinzao, AP Sinzao, with Ignite is doing a whole lot this
AP Sinzao was... I don't know why.
Does he want
did
a split
that?
Push? Does he want a team fight? Like, I'm not a big AP Zin, you know. That's not my forte. But
I think
feel
there
like
might
be
some disrespect there. What are you thinking?
I don't think so.
No?
I think that that's just something he thinks he can carry with.
Yeah? Interesting. I don't know. I've seen AP Sinzao.
It's good. If you can get like 3-4 items on it, you actually heal so much. If you have the attack speed, you can like 1v3 if you are in the right situation. However,
interesting.
They're just running at them. They're just team fighting over and over and over and over again. And Sinzao is just going in and dying. They just don't have the right team comp to play with. Like, what's
Thresh
the point?
And Tahm say hello to each other and walk away.
That's like my social life too, dude. Nice. Nice.
Thresh trying to get some wards down. That's good. Dragon is up in 1.5 minutes.
Yeah, so you see those deep wards all the way back there. Mm-hmm. Obviously, they know where they are.
Yeah,
they can just force
sure.
a fight whenever they want. Wrath picking up red. Bottom lane pushing slightly. I mean, unless there's some massive misplays from Team Vaughn here, they could actually find a good fight. They do see Caitlyn's going to show top. If they can find a pick off of this, it'd pretty much be their best opportunity, but the red team is not done. They will back up.
Well, okay, now this is what I'm thinking. Chris has her Infinity Edge. There's a power spike there, and she does have the crit cloak and the Zeal. If she stands back and autos, possibly do something. Zed going on to Sinzao and dropping the ultimate, doing so much damage. Sinzao did not have time to retaliate there.
Nope.
He didn't even see that coming.
And definitely just got dumped on.
So to speak, yes. And it looks like they're putting Zed into a split push roll all of a sudden for some reason.
probably just waiting for the next dragon, I believe. Zed will walk over some wards, though, if he keeps traveling this way. Could get picked off by Lee Sin and Trist if they know what's up. His ultimate is down, for sure. And, no, okay, so these guys are just
the red team
fearing.
Just doesn't even really care anymore. They're just kind of playing. Like, they're not shot calling, they're not doing anything. They're just playing their own game. They got a huge wave top, they could go race it up there if they want, but Zed is just, like, 1v4ing in the bottom lane. Caitlyn's trying to get her items completed, you know, farming jungle camps and stuff like that, waiting for Dragon. They will pick up their second. This game is just kind of all over the place.
It's pretty much over, though, I think.
Oh, for sure.
Wow, Zed has so much energy. Look at him. Ultimate there. Stun on Trist.
He's got fucked up. Just got dunked on.
Looks like Uter's going bear stance behind him to get some gauge on this team. Thresh dies right away. Lee Sin takes a lot of damage from Zed's march, but does not fall. Easy tower here. Sin Zhao pushing the top lane for some reason, not helping his team.
Yeah, he's gonna TP in. Oh, wait. No, he's not!
That was
he did get his Lich Bane,
headshot.
Though. He did get his Lich Bane. You know,
can't do much with that now.
You can't do this as the diamond player on your team. You cannot do this. You're not gonna win a game. You need to be in a position where you can be with your team and shot calling.
Yeah,
if you're a diamond player, this is honestly probably his first tournament. I don't see his name. I've never seen it before. It's not something I remember. This is probably him coming in and being, oh, solo queue hero, playing up to the name of the tournament. That's not the way these tournaments are played. Yeah. That's not the way they're won. And hopefully he's learned from that. He's got a lot of guys with experience on his team. Mr. Mortified, he's got, you know, Melee's, like I said, a hugely strong player. But just really disappointing play from the blue team here. They are not working well together.
Huh. There's not much to say in the race now. Like, if they were slightly, like, further in the game, Lee Sin did land a great Q, could dash in, insect Caitlyn into the team, do something. But right now, they're just wave clearing.
I don't know if they have enough damage even to kill him, though.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Maybe with the Syndra, but whoa.
They're just getting poked down.
Here we go. It's your opportunity, Lee. Doesn't have a flash. Yeah, that's just. I mean, they're not gonna have enough damage. That happens.
Wow, that Zed has so much damage.
Yeah.
Tom. Oh my God. Nearly double kill. Zed does fall to Tristana. Syndra gets a double, triple kill. Sorry, LeBlanc.
Tom Kench needs to be a little bit quicker on this reaction time. I would say. He could have ate that Zed.
He could have. Yes.
Get those calories. You know, calories in, calories out. You know what I'm saying?
That's a pretty fat Zed to eat, too.
Yeah, dude.
7-4 and 10. Lee Sin trying to answer, but nothing there for him.
Catfish with a fancy. Yeah, this is just a matter of time. A good look for the red team here. I'd say just relying on their strong lanes. Not really playing a smart game. Just kind of the solo queue game.
No. Yeah, this
really
is definitely just solo lane dominance.
Yeah.
And just taking it all the way.
Yep. Tanky Nugs obviously showing his adaptability. Playing top lane in the first lane, playing mid lane in the second game.
That's another thing that really helps flexibility in tournaments like this.
Yep.
Someone can't play one role if you have the ability to play two
roles.
They
dodged that diamond matchup.
Yeah, for sure. They put him in the mid lane, they took the advantage, and they're really rolled with it. Whereas Batman Bread wasn't able to do much. I really like that name though.
Do you?
Batman? I like Batman. And
you like bread?
I like bread. Yes, I do like bread. Not sure what Batman bread is though.
It's bread. You know how you take like bologna and you like eat like the like shape in a circle and you can make like a little star or whatever?
Mm-hmm.
You do that with the bread and you eat like a little Batman. And then you put it over a light and it's the Batman symbol.
Get out of here.
And you asked.
Alright. Looks like they want to answer the bear.
Have you ever heard of a guy named I think his name is Mixmaster Mike? You ever heard of? No, I don't think that's his name. It's not Mixmaster Mike. It's what's his name?
have no idea what you're talking about.
There's a video, and he's like a YouTube rapper. He's absolutely hilarious.
Okay.
God, something Mike. Magic Mike or something like that. Not Magic Mike.
Wow, Cinder just got destroyed.
He does a song called Dunked On, and it's all about him dunking on a guy and how like he starts crying after he gets dunked on. Okay. And I kind of feel like that's
Zed goes in for the ultimate onto Xin Zhao, drops a lot of damage, will not die. Caitlyn with the ace in the hole, blocked by. Wow, this is just all over the place.
If you guys are out there in the Twitch clan, just Google "just got dunked on." I'm actually gonna play it on stream after this because it is it's a good one.
So
absolute domination, and to quote Moneymaker Mike, "You just got dunked on."
Syndra getting the retribution kill there at the end. Isn't it? Good game by Red Team, 13-31. I like that.
It's Moneymaker Mike is his like sidekick. And it's we gotta watch it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry.
I apologize for this man's behavior.
Moneymaker Mike, bro. Here we go.
Alright, let's see this.
This is basically what happened in this game. Froggy Fresh, that's his name. Alright, ladies and gentlemen.
Moneymaker Mike,
you ready
and
for this?
Froggy Fresh. All right.
Oh, I gotta turn on the volume. Here we go.
Out on the court for a game of 2-on-2. Me and Mike versus James and his boy Big Blue. We headed off to Kevin's house right after school, cause he got that new lifetime basketball hoop. We came ready. We came ready to play. We came ready to win and bring the trophy home that day. Big Blue said, "You ain't bringing home that W. How you gonna score when I'm standing here in front of you?" I grabbed the ball and I passed it into Mike. Mike caught the pass, fake left and went right. He drove through the lane and he threw it off the glass. I couldn't believe my eyes, he was running so fast. Caught the pass in midair, then he threw that boy down. Nobody could believe it, James fell over on the ground. He started crying, put his hands on his head. Then Big Blue looked at me and Mike and he said, "Why's James crying?"
Cause he just got dunked on.
I ain't even lying.
Yo, he just got dunked on.
Yep, he was standing in the way. So I jumped up in the air and I ducked it on his face. Why's James crying?
Cause he just got dunked on.
I ain't even lying.
Yo, he just got dunked on.
Yep, he was standing in the way. So I jumped up in the air and I ducked it.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is exactly what just happened to the blue team.
So blue team just got dunked on.
Yep.
And are they crying? That is the question.
Yep.
So, how would they have won this game?
I ain't even lying. How would they have won?
Yeah.
Probably by not picking AP Xinzhou. I'm going to throw that out there.
Yeah.
You just can't do that. Now it's your diamond. You got to carry the team.
Well, let's look at the damage here, shall we?
Yes, let's look at the damage, shall we? We will jump into the damage meters. If that will not work for me, sadly. Okay. Well, that's too bad.
It's all right. We can see Zed and Caitlyn are just like 10th and 20th.
I mean, that's just basically
what
this team is all about. You know what I mean? They've got the strong duo queue, and they demolish.
That's ridiculous.
Yep.
Yeah, Syndra tried to do stuff that game. You said that
she just
would
got
fall
stomped
back.
In lane, right?
Yeah, but, you know, she still tried.
She did.
A valiant effort from blue team.
Yeah. All right. So, my name is Muscabat. I am joined by Razor8. Razor8.
I did 8.
Nice.
Yes.
We'll be back in a little bit with some more fantastic solo queue games.
Thanks, guys.